Hi everyone, and welcome to your hip health workout. This workout is great for anyone to perform, but it's especially important for our young athletes to decrease that risk for the lower extremity injury. So we're actually going to start with a little bit of a spinal mobilization here. You're going to be down on your stomach. You can notice I have my feet turned in just to relax the muscles in my bottom. Hands are underneath my shoulders. I press all the way up, keeping my back and buttocks relaxed. Lifting up, hold one, two, exhale at the top and back down. We're doing 5 repetitions just like this to get our back loosened up. And now we're gonna bend our knees and do the same thing, 5 repetitions. This just helps to stretch out the front of the hips a little bit more the same time you're stretching out your back. If you've had an assessment with me, you know this move also helps to improve that hip strength and mobility to get you ready for your workout. This is just a nice, easy warm-up before we go into our first hip strengthening exercise. So you're gonna go ahead, you're gonna lay on your right side first, left leg up. Your bottom knee is gonna be bent. Your top leg is gonna go slightly behind you and then up at about a 45-degree angle. My stomach is tight, back is flat, toes pointed straight forward, lifting up in a slow, controlled movement. We're gonna do 15 repetitions here, and you should feel this in your bottom. If you don't, you probably need to bring your leg back just a little bit more. This is our last rep, and we're gonna go into a bicycle or a runner. So your leg is still up, you're doing a nice smooth circle with that left leg, stomach still pulled in tight. We're gonna do 15 repetitions here. Good, one more repetition here. Now you're gonna straighten your leg out again and you're gonna make circles with your hip. We're gonna go backwards or counterclockwise with that left leg first. Leg stays straight, stomach stays tight, smooth circles, 15 repetitions counterclockwise, and then we're gonna switch and do clockwise. There we go, switch, 15 circles the other direction. After this, we're gonna go ahead and flip over and do your right leg. Excellent. Now we're gonna flip over. You're gonna be laying on your left side. Right side's going to be up. I'm just showing you a different angle. I'm putting my thumb right on that muscle we're supposed to be working. It's called the gluteus medius. So again, you bring your leg slightly back and then lift up. If you don't feel that muscle right where my thumb is at, you probably just need to extend your leg or bring it back a little bit further. Stomach is tight, 15 repetitions here, and then we're gonna go into those bicycles or runners. Perfect, time to switch. 15 of the bicycles. Excellent. Straighten out that leg, and now we're going to make those circles. On the right side, we're starting with clockwise circles. Nice, slow and controlled, 15 repetitions, and then we'll switch and do counterclockwise circles. You should start to feel that burn on your leg. You might feel it in both legs at this point. Go ahead, switch directions, 15 repetitions. After this, we're going to repeat one more set, but only on one leg. I would assume that either myself or another physical therapist has told you that you have one leg that's weaker than the other, or you notice yourself that one leg is weaker than the other. So for the leg that is weak, we are going to perform another set to try to keep our body balanced and get it as strong as our other leg. I'm showing you here, you can also add a resistance band above your knees to increase the challenge and the amount of resistance given at that muscle. If it was already hard enough without the band, go ahead and do it without the band for now and you can build up to this. So my right side is my weaker side, so I'm doing another set on this side. So 15 repetitions, going back and up, stomach pulled in tight. Good, and keeping that hip up and leg up, now into the bicycles or runners. 15 repetitions, and then we'll do our other circles with the leg straight. Okay, straighten that leg out. We're gonna do our clockwise circles. If you're doing it on your right leg, if you're doing your left leg, it'll be counterclockwise circles. Nice, slow and controlled. You should feel a little bit more of a burn, especially on this second set here. 15 reps, and then we'll change directions. Good, other direction. After this, we're gonna be doing some standing exercises to activate this muscle functionally, which will help you improve your sport and control while you're standing, running, and jumping. All right, it is time to stand up. Go ahead, you can take that resistance band off. If you've done this workout a few times now, you can keep the resistance band on for this next workout, but if it's your first time or you're still experiencing some weakness in the hips, go ahead and take it off. So now we're gonna do the same exercise, but in standing, so it challenges that muscle a little bit more. We're gonna start standing on your right leg, toes pointed straight forward, knee is right over your foot, and that left leg is going back into the side at that 45 degree angle, just like we did when we were laying on your side. The difference here is now you are using that muscle both on the leg you are kicking out, but it's also keeping you stable on the leg you are standing on. Now we're gonna switch to your left leg, 15 repetitions. Nice sturdy frame, stomach tight. I'm just pointing with my right hand where you should feel it in your bottom. You should also feel it on the leg you are standing on. It should actually be harder on the leg you're standing on because that muscle is stabilizing you while you are standing on it. Good, just showing you that different angle again so you can see my hip is slightly extended and going off to the side. Excellent, we're gonna challenge that muscle even more. You're gonna grip with your right toes, push your right knee out, try to keep it centered over your foot, and you're gonna tap in four directions. You're gonna tap forward, back into the side, straight back, and into a curtsy. We're gonna do 10 reps each direction. Your biggest focus is keeping that right or stance leg stable. You can see it's challenging. Focus on gripping your toes on that right side, pushing that knee out so that you stay nice and sturdy. Forward, back to the side, straight back, and back across. This should be challenging on your stance leg. This is my right side, so this is my little bit weaker, so we will be doing a second set on the right. Good job. Now we're gonna be standing on your left leg. Focus is staying nice and sturdy on that left leg, gripping with the toes, knee is centered over your toes. Step forward, out to the side, back, and behind you. It does not matter how far you step, I only want you to step out as far as you can keep control on the leg you are standing on. So if it's just a short, small step, that's fine. You will build up to reaching further. 10 repetitions each direction, just like we did on the other leg. Great job. All right, just like I said, we're gonna do an extra set on one side. My right leg is my weaker leg, so I'm doing an extra set on my right leg. So if yours is your right leg, follow exactly like I do. If you have been told or you know your left leg is weaker, you're going to be performing this standing on your left leg. So we're doing the same thing, tapping in four directions. Just like before on the mat, I added a resistance band to make it a little bit more challenging. If this still feels too hard or challenging without the band, do it without, you will build up to this. We're doing 10 taps each direction. Go ahead, you can take that resistance band off. We have one more exercise we're going to repeat on each leg, and this is the most challenging. This whole program has gradually progressed by increasing the challenge. Now we're going to do what's called a step down. So it's a little bit more of a challenge than even just stepping on a level surface. The focus is the same. You're trying to keep your knee centered over your toes and your foot as you tap down. So really focus, we're starting that left leg first, keep that knee centered over your foot, tap down with your right heel. I'm gonna change directions just so you can see my form from the side. Bottom is going behind you, tapping that right heel down, nice, slow, controlled motion. We're doing 10 reps and then we're gonna switch to the other side. At home, you can use a step stool, you can use a step in your house, anything that elevates you just a little bit so that it's more challenging than just doing it on the ground with the last few exercises. Good. Here we're tapping down with the left foot, standing on the right. You can see I'm trying to keep that knee centered over my foot. Again, I told you my right leg's a little bit weaker, so you might notice I have a little less control, and that's why I'm working on this as well. Stomach tight, bottom goes behind you. Really focusing on that knee control. Again, if this feels too challenging at this height, you start at a lower height. You can start from 1 inch, 2 inches, build up to a foot. We're gonna repeat one more set on your weak side. Mine is my right, so I'm repeating on the right. If yours is the same, follow along. Otherwise, do another set standing on your left leg. Most important part is that nice, slow, controlled movement. Keeping that knee centered. This will make it so that when you are playing your sport, when you are running, when you are jumping, when you land, you will have a sturdy, strong knee and decrease that risk for injury. Excellent. We're gonna end with the same stretch we did at the beginning, just to make sure everything's lined up. Good, I'm just gonna do 3 reps with my legs straight, feet turned in, and 3 reps with my knees bent. This is our level 1 workout for that hip health, decreasing your risk for injury, but it is so important to maintain your health and strength for your sport. Try to perform this as much as your therapist recommended. Initially, you should be doing it 3 times a week. Eventually, you should maintain doing it at least 1 time a week to keep your hips strong and healthy. Everyone did amazing today. Thank you for joining me. If you have any questions, reach out to me at jamie@theratrain.org or visit my website, theratrain.org. Have a great day and see you soon.